Hello and welcome into Burner, where today we continue our Road to Ramen series. In this video, part 1, we will be making the broth for the medieval noodles, which are the subject of part 2. To make this, we'll be following a recipe from the Song Dynasty, using lamb, spring onion, pepper, and a secret ingredient. It was written down in the cookbook
Shan Jia Qing Gong.
Thank you. A cookbook by Song Dynasty statesman and poet Lin Hong. Even though he was a poet, this recipe is not a poem. In the upcoming episode, we will see why this is a good thing. The recipe contained in his book, the Shan Jia Qing Gong. Thank you. The recipe itself is very simple. Take mutton or lamb neck, put it in a clay pot. We don't have a clay pot, so we're using cast iron. Flood it with water, add in green onions and Sichuan peppercorns. So far, nothing special. But this is where it gets interesting. The
Shan Jia Qing Gong
itself calls it the secret ingredient. This secret ingredient is apricot kernel. You might not find this in your local supermarket, but Asian shops and health food shops tend to stock this. If you're buying this from a Chinese shop, you might have to look for dried almond rather than apricot kernel. It's a long story. It comes in both whole and ground form. If you have the whole ones, lightly crush them up and put them in your soup. Now, bring all of this to a boil and leave it there until the meat falls off the bones. Should be a couple of hours. One other thing where this recipe differs from a lot of broth recipes is that it instructs us to do all of this over a live flame. In other words, slightly higher heat than usual. This will result in a cloudier broth, differing from the clear soups which you see in most Chinese broths these days. There is a further part to this recipe, but it is a short poetic flourish about how it is a shame that this was not available during the Han Dynasty. It is, however, at the end and does not impede our understanding of the recipe, which is something that will never happen later. If you want to see how we use this broth, make sure to subscribe. Once our broth is ready and the meat is falling over the bones, we're going to sieve it. Now that we have our broth, we're going to place it on a cooling rack so it cools down quickly, as we don't want bacteria getting too comfy in there. Broth that isn't eaten straight away should be fridged or frozen. We are fridging half of it in these airtight jars and freezing the other half in a bag. The frozen stock will last a few months. The stock merely chilled should be consumed within a week though. Also make sure to bring it to a boil again before consumption. So, what do we eat this stock with? Well, for that you'll have to check out our next video, which will be released a week after this one. In this video, we will make the noodles and the toppings that complete the soup. We hope you enjoyed this video on how to make medieval Chinese broth. Please leave a like if you did, it really means the world to us. Thank you very much for watching.